How can you consistently tell stories with your data when the data might be changing on a daily basis? In this short video, I'm going to share with you my experiences of how I do this as a consultant for many years. Firstly, before we do anything, we have to appreciate that there are two high-level things we need: rapid iteration and an agile process that we can follow that covers requirements gathering, insight design, and a launch sequence. Now, without those, let me just tell you right now, it's impossible to consistently tell stories with your data that have an impact on the business. So check out my other content on those topics, but for now, let's just assume we have those in place. We're going to jump right in and look at what ingredients we actually need for this thing to work. We need a goal, our goals, that have leadership buy-in and can be measured. We get these from the stakeholders, our executives. A goal is fine, but we need people acting towards that goal. These are the end users, the people that will be taking the actual action based on the stories coming from our insights. We also need an interface to both expose the stories through and for our end users to engage with. And this is typically the dashboard where we have our charts and various visualizations, of course. Finally, we have our outcomes, effectively the so what of why are we doing any of this? Can we measure the impact of our end users acting on the data stories that are bringing us closer to the goals we defined at the outset? Now, this begs several questions. For example, what if we don't have leadership buy-in to help define the goals if there are no goals in existence? A very common situation and pretty much a deal breaker if you want to make a major impact on the business. It really doesn't mean you shouldn't continue, but you do need to set realistic expectations on your chances of success being dramatically reduced. There are other avenues available to you, which I discuss elsewhere in some of my other content. For now, let's just jump into the interface so we can talk about how to craft a story for a specific goal. Let's say we are a product company that sells products to our distributors. We have a goal, which is to increase our annual gross sales by 5%. And having spoken to both management and the product owners who are end users, we know a typical scenario is that our distributors run out of stock regularly and miss out on sales because of it. Having looked at this historically, we estimate that some 20,000 units accounted for our inventory shortfall, so we are going to build a view or a tab for this scenario in a dashboard. Since our end users are the product owners, we will use an operational type of layout. And in this layout, we put our navigation at the top, key performance indicators below those, and our charts and filters occupying the main portion of the dashboard. Since we have a goal of increasing gross revenue, let's put a KPI in there to reflect that. As we report out monthly, we'll add a month-on-month trend to that KPI. Of course, since the behavior we are driving is to minimize inventory shortfall, we want a number up there to reflect that. To add a so what element, we're going to estimate the gross revenue impact of not addressing this shortfall. This is so the product owner knows what money they're leaving on the table, and they know that their management knows this also. So that could be awkward if they don't act on it. Now, let's move on here to the action. The big numbers here at the top tell us what's at stake, the risk and the potential reward if we can act on it. If you have attended any of my courses, live seminars, you know that I like to have all my charts in a tab work together to tell a story. You'll also know I love bubble charts. They are not for every application, of course, but here it can work really well for we have lots of things, and things in this case being products. We can see from our KPIs at the top that our attention is being drawn to the orange ones. We have some problems, clearly. The story in this case is that we have an inventory shortfall of 20,000 units, and it is the potential revenue impact of 2 million that's really concerning us here. From our bubble chart, we know the major offenders are with these three products we see in the top left. So if we want to make an impact, we should deal with these three first. That is, the product owner would prioritize these three and take action on them. This action is aligned with our goals, and has the so what of minimizing revenue loss and thus increasing our gross revenue. Now, with this example, you can see how we can tell a story for a given scenario that is aligned to a goal. However, if there are 1,000 product owners and only 10% of our users are adopting the dashboard, then again, we're leaving money on the table. A successful process maximizes adoption, and the best storytelling in the world doesn't help with that. We need to be able to drive adoption and get people into the experience so we can scale the impact of action that people are taking. But that's for another day. If you like this video, you're going to love my free training. Just go to deliveringdataanalytics.com and navigate to the free training page to get yourself signed up. I promise it'll make you look at success in the enterprise differently. Also, all the young people are talking about it. Check out my book, Delivering Data Analytics, available on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and many other reputable outlets. And finally, you might also be interested in one of our kits that make your life so much easier when you're working with stakeholders. I'm Nicholas Kelly from Delivering Data Analytics, and thank you very much for your time.